Trawley may have contracted the bacteria in September.
The wall on Sandy Cathan's home is filled with images of her late son. His ashes are still in the house and will be scattered next year. She's holding on to every memory of what would have been her firstborn child. The 27-year-old says she was due to give birth in December, but went into labor on the 2nd of September instead.
Mm-hmm. He was born in 25 weeks, which is like 5 months. So he weighed 1.11 kgs. He was fine. He was in our ICU for about 3-4 days, and then they moved him to neonate, or whichever maternity ward that was. From there, he had a downfall. They said that he had infection. Nobody could actually tell me what it was.
9 infants died of bacterial infection in this hospital, which mostly occurs in premature newborns.
He had like hiccups, but the thing is, I'm not a doctor, so I can't say if that, but you could see he had like trouble breathing.
Last week, human rights officials who visited the facility death as a violation of their right to access to health care.
I'd like an investigation to basically be taken place to investigate if there's any further more deaths.
The health department says experts are looking into the outbreak during the period of March and August this year, and officials would also be in contact with Cathan. The department says major steps have been taken to prevent further outbreaks. Malunge Lupoi, Johannesburg.